Implementing our side stream program was a huge change, and obviously a big part of that was the people end of things. We've got 8 people who work back here in the brewery, and we spent a lot of time trying to help everybody understand why it was that we had to make these changes and what the materials were that we had to identify and then put to one side rather than putting down the drain as we had in the past. So one easy way that we came up with to try and remember that was the saying, color, chunks, and acid. So basically, if you're standing there and trying to decide, does this go down the drain or does this go to side stream? If it's got color in it, if it has solids in it, or if it's acidic, it's got to be side stream and everything else can go. So for side streaming to work, you've got to have a place where you can actually collect all of the material, which is exactly what's going on here. This is a sump that we sank into the floor and where we direct all of the material that we don't want to send down the drain. And instead it gets pumped out to a tank outside where it can be held and then vacuumed out by a disposal company. So you can see here, we've got hoses connected in from various points in the process. It all dumps down into the tank. Then there's a pump at the bottom that directs this to a master collection point at the edge of the brewery. We have this one sump set up here beside our brew house and some of our fermenters. We have another sump further back in the brewery that collects out of our centrifuge and some more of our fermentation and bright tanks. And then that all ultimately goes to a master collection point and out to the tanks. This is one of those things that I really wish we'd been able to do sooner. I mean, you may be able to see here, we had to cut into the floor in order to install this thing. It was a major hassle to retrofit the brewery with all of these collection points. It would have been much easier to plan in at the beginning. So we've got side streaming set up throughout the entire brewery, and through a combination of gravity drain and pumps, it all directs back here. So what you can see going down into this master collection point, we've got our secondary drainage set up on our brew house for high strength material. We've got our discharge from our keg washer. We've got discharge from our can line and the collection tray we have on there. We even have actually the beer spillage out of our retail store directing into here. And once the material gets down into this collection point, it runs out to a pair of outdoor tanks with a total volume of about 45,000 liters. We have a vacuum hauler that comes by periodically, takes that stuff away, and it actually gets turned into fertilizer. We implemented our side streaming program in phases, and what we found was that to get from okay results to really good results, we had to really start sweating the small stuff. And that's where this comes from. Just under here on our can line, we've actually installed a drip tray that covers the entire bottom of the line. What that does is it grabs all of the beer spillage off of our can filler, directs it down into this sump here, and then from there it gets pumped up into the master collection point further forward in the brewery. We never thought that the beer spillage off of our can line would have been enough to matter, but it turned out that it did. We ran the math, and this stuff alone was enough to blow our results for the entire day, let alone everything else we were doing in the brewery. Filtration in any brewery can be a huge source of high strength material. What you can see behind us here is actually our centrifuge filter. Now this is something that we bought a few years ago when we were doing maybe around 8,000 hectoliters a year. And we didn't buy it explicitly for wastewater management. We actually bought it for the efficiency gains that it got us when we were filtering out of our fermenters and into our bright tanks. As it's turned out, implementing our side streaming regime here, it's been extremely helpful. Like it sounds, a centrifuge works by spinning your beer around extremely rapidly and removing solids that are discharged out of the side of the filter. So no back flushing, no pads to get rid of. And what we found with this is we could just pipe it directly into our side streaming system and the contents would just get pumped to outside. Ultimately, something that was a good business investment for starters has turned into an even better investment now that we're doing more to control our wastewater. What I've got beside me here is the control system that runs our flow balancing tank. So what happens here is all of the discharge that's coming out of the brewery and ultimately going to the sewer runs through a flow balancing tank that's controlled by this machine. So what happens is the effluent goes in, it gets mixed and blended so that we can smooth out process spikes. We measure the pH, dose in caustic as needed to adjust it. And then once everything is ready to go, it gets discharged out, and then the volume is measured on its way out to the sewer.